done. Did you ever think Netlink would come back? I was starting to think it wouldn't. Well, here we are, so. It did come back. When the GTX 1080 launched, some leaks came out indicating that Nvidia would skip the M variant and just put full desktop cards in laptops like they did with the 980 and some of those gaming notebooks. Well, now new leaks have come out from Swedish notebook manufacturer Ivy, more or less confirming that there will indeed be a GTX 1080 M with a slightly slower base clock speed of 1442 MHz and GDDR5 memory instead of GDDR5. X. Notebooks with the actual card inside are supposed to launch at the end of July, so guys, will you just settle down? Because we'll know for sure then, so just chill, okay? Jeez. Researchers at the University of California have gone a little overboard and created a processor with 1,000 cores. 1,000! Each of the cores operate at 1.78 GHz and can communicate directly with each other rather than having a shared memory cache like regular CPUs. They can also shut down when they're not being used, which helps keep the power requirement down so much that the whole thing can be run off a single AA battery. Wow. So what does this mean for consumer chips? Nothing. You're not getting this. The way this will work is Intel chips will get jealous and grow more cores to compensate. That's how life works. Nature. Speaking of Intel processors, strangely, there's none of those in the fastest supercomputer in the world. The Sunway Taihu Lite was built and designed in China and is capable of hitting 93 quadrillion floating point operations per second, or petaflops if you're into abbreviating. That makes it nearly three times faster than the previous supercomputing champ, the Tianhe 2, also from China. Meanwhile, the closest US competitor only manages a measly 17 pentaflops. Like, what's that good for? Replacing a graphing calculator? It's time for... Sir, few may know this, but my nickname was Keys because I play piano, so I want to let you know I appreciate you, okay? Don't stop. Thanks for your submission. Send us a clip of yourself saying quick bits to get featured on Netlinked. The rest of you. That guy already sent it, obviously. Nvidia has announced the PCIe version of its Tesla P100 GPU. It was initially announced in a custom form factor using Nvidia's Mezzanine connector, so now professional customers will have something to plug into a more familiar connector. Input on the Steam controller can now be customized even more, with long presses and double taps being added to the device's repertoire as part of the Activator's update. Is there nothing it can't do? Yes, lots. Intel does not hold on to their roadmaps that well, as another one has leaked showing Kaby Lake processors launching in December. Tumblr will be launching live video streaming very shortly because they want to do what the other cool kids are doing, and I don't know, Tumblr, but I think you should be true to you and live your true life, whatever that means for you. Microsoft made a video to show what everyone knew already. Chrome eats battery life like hurtful YouTube comments eat my self-esteem. That's great, Microsoft, but get some extensions going. And then we'll talk. And the Zungle Panther is a pair of sunglasses on Kickstarter that double as wireless bone conduction headphones. Stay aware of your surroundings while listening to music. Confuse your friends. It's a win-win. New sources for all of today's stories can be found in the forum post linked in the description. The HTC Vive does what Nintendo don't. You got it right, Joao. Even if I didn't get your name right. Hey, did you see that unboxing we did a while back? Intel sent us a bunch of swag and a pass to PAX West because they're running a contest called the Intel Extreme Rig Challenge. What the heck is that? I'll tell ya. 12 system builders were sent Intel's new Broadwell E processors and a 750 series PCIe SSD, including NCIX's own PC division, NCIX PC. They're each using those components to make an extreme gaming rig. You must vote for which one you think is the best, and based on your votes, 7 of the 12 will be sent to PAX West and will be given away to 7 lucky fans. The rigs will be given away to 7 people. So, how do you enter? You enter by voting. Tweet the name or handle of your favorite system builder and include the hashtag IntelRigChallenge to both vote for them and enter yourself in the raffle to win a rig. Now, if you want to vote for NCIXPC, use hashtag NCIX. Please. Please use that hashtag. No one's stopping you from using a different one, but no one's also stopping you from eating an entire box of Oreos on a whim, so you know what the right thing to do in both of those situations is. All right, that's it for Netlink Daily, guys. Thanks for watching. Click here to watch more videos. Follow us on Twitter over here, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this from NCIX. Now, this episode is going to end now, and then we're going to edit it and put it up tomorrow. And then more episodes will go up after this one. So don't worry, this isn't like the only video we have. We have lots. So they're over here. You can click on them. Okay? Are we good? Okay. Now go do something else while you're waiting for the next one to come up. It'll be ready. It'll be, just go play or something. Cool.